Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube, and this morning we're going to be talking some golf, we're going to talk some travel, we've got a bunch of great travel deals for you later in the show, and joining me this morning, we've got Steve, the morning man, filling in for Mike, who is on the Legends Cruise this week, and having a great time, but he is missed, so it's a pleasure to have you with us, Steve.
Well, it's a pleasure to be pushing the buttons for you and making sure we don't launch anything out of the ground in Nebraska.
That's okay. Pulling double duty, so we appreciate it. Thank you. And as we always do, we're going to kind of recap what's going on in the world of golf first. A little bit of a tip of the hat to what went on last week. Russell Henley, congratulations to him. He won on the PGA Tour in Mayacoba, Mexico. I believe he's won fourth win. So congratulations to him. It was a very strong field and he prevailed. Different story on the women's tour. On the LPGA Tour, congratulations go out to Gemma Dryberg. And if her name doesn't sound familiar, it's because this is the first time she's ever won. This was over in Japan. I always like when they play over in Asia because being a night owl, I get to watch it live at midnight or so, which is always pretty good because there's not much else to watch on TV at that hour. And on the Champions Tour, right in our backyard in Boca Raton, Bernhard Langer, 65 years old, won for the 44th time on the Champions Tour. Just amazing. He's a machine. Of course, he's a Boca Raton resident, so it was right in his backyard. Last week, we actually had the vice president from Tour Edge Golf, which he plays their clubs, and many of the players on the Champions Tour do, and Bernhard was asked about if he's thinking about retirement yet at 65, and he said he's thinking about it. So we asked John from Tour Edge if there's any truth to that, and John said he's never going to retire. Don't listen to a word he's saying. So he keeps shooting lower than his age, which is remarkable at 65 years old to be shooting lower than 65 on a regular basis, and the guy's a machine. So we're going to look for him a little bit later today because finishing up later today on the tour is the championship, actually, for the senior set, the Champions Tour, the Charles Schwab Cup, and he's competing, I think, so that should be good to see. Also, finishing up later today on the PGA Tour, the Houston Open, so that'll be fun to watch as well. In other golf news, announced this past week that the Match, Capital One The Match, is coming back again. That's the made-for-TV event where they have two twosomes square off against each other. The big news is our neighbor from up the road, Tiger Woods, will be playing this year, teaming up with Rory McIlroy, playing against another local, Justin Thomas, and Jordan Spieth. So that's going to take place on Saturday, December 10th, under the lights, 6 p.m. They're lighting up the golf course here in Florida at the Pelican Golf Club in Bel Air. So I'm going to be excited to watch that. Actually, Tiger just announced also, not a surprise, that he will be playing in his own event in the Bahamas in a couple of weeks. So Tiger is back, and not only is he back, but he just pocketed several million dollars, I believe, from the Player Impact Program, which is a program that was set up by the PGA Tour a couple of years ago to put money in the pocket of like the top 20 players based upon the amount of media they generate, positive publicity for the tour. So kind of remarkable that Tiger played like two or three events and still got more publicity than anybody else on the tour did. They're kind of tweaking this program a little bit, and some of that has to do with the LIV golf tour and all that money that's involved. They're trying to make sure that the players that did not go over to the LIV tour are appeased and happy. Speaking of which, there were some rumors that came out this past week that possibly Greg Norman, who of course is the CEO of the LIV Tour, may get kicked upstairs. There was some editorials, I saw one in Golf Week, as a matter of fact, that it's due to Greg Norman's incompetence and replacing him won't solve the problem. But there's talk that the ex-CEO from TaylorMade, maybe even though he denied it, it seems that denial and then change of mind is very common on the LIV Golf Tour. All the players have done it, so I guess the CEOs are doing it too. We also have some condolences. Bryson DeChambeau, his father passed away this past week, so condolences to him and to his family. Also, maybe condolences are due for a golf course. Right here in our backyard, this fight has been going on for a while. Lone Pine over in Riviera Beach, a public course that's relatively inexpensive, been around for a long time. They're trying to rezone it and build houses there. Obviously, the people who live there are not very pleased with that. I live on a golf course. I know if they turned around and got rid of the golf course and put houses in my backyard instead of the lovely ninth hole that I back up to, I'd be pretty unhappy too. Not to mention the fact that golf is expensive, and the residents of Riviera Beach, by nature, not the most affluent area of Palm Beach County, and a lot of these people are going to be out of luck. The owner of the golf course claims that, you know, it's not profitable and he can't keep it open, and it seems nobody is stepping up to buy the golf course and maintain it, and Riviera Beach as a city, they don't want to get into the golf course business either. It's a difficult business. Obviously, with the hurricanes that we've been experiencing, that's also been a drag on revenue for golf courses. It makes it very, very difficult. Also in the news this past week, we heard Angel Cabrera. He's been in jail in his home country of Argentina for beating up his wife, and now he got sentenced to another term for beating up his girlfriend. He claims it's done him good. He had problems with alcohol, blames it on that, and he says that jail is not always a bad thing. It gave him some time to reflect, and he's going to be a better person when he comes out, and hopefully he'll be back on the Champions Tour if they welcome him back. So hopefully that will happen, so we will see. All right, I think it's time for our first break. So what we're going to do is take a very, very quick break. I got one or two more golf stories. I got a little bit of travel news for you. You won't want to miss any of it, so please stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook.
Hi, golf and travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
When you see me tee up, you better step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. I hook it to the left, I shank it to the right. I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt.
And we are back, and as promised, a tiny bit more golf news for you. The LPGA announced that Athiah Thitikal made it as the Rookie of the Year. It's based upon wins and points, so it's not a vote of any kind, but she had a tremendous rookie year, so congratulations to her. Also, a little more condolences. Dow Finsterwald, he was the first PGA champion in stroke play. The Broadmoor, for like over 20 years, he was their head professional out in Colorado Springs. I've met the man. Just a wonderful, wonderful man. Big, big guy in the history of golf. Passed away this past week at the age of 93. I spoke to him maybe 3 or 4 years ago, and he was spry as could be at almost 90. So just a great representative of the world of golf. He will certainly be missed. Also, one other story. This is an interesting story. Athletes who play high levels of sports, professional sports, love to play golf. The reason they love to play golf is they've always been so good at the sport that they've done. Golf is a challenge for them. And many of these professional athletes who are at the top of their game, they say that golf is the most difficult sport of all. So all of you who think it's not even a sport, it's just a hobby, not so. It was just announced this past week that Vikings quarterback Kirk Cousins decided to buy the Allegan County Golf Course, which is like near his hometown in Michigan. The golf course was up for sale. He lives in the area. He was concerned that maybe the course would be redeveloped, like we just spoke about in Riviera Beach, and it wouldn't be around for the residents. And he decided to step up and buy the golf course so that it remains there for him and for the other people in the community. And I like him even more now than I used to like him before. Not only a great quarterback, but doing the right thing for the community. So kudos to Kirk Cousins. Let's change gears a little bit. There's been a lot of news in the travel industry recently about the size of seats in airplanes. Maybe you've noticed it, but with the economy airlines that have come into play, seat space has gotten smaller. They're narrower. There's less leg room. There have been many situations where people are upset that other people are kind of infringing on their space, their personal space. For a while, airlines were charging larger people, you know, more money if you were too large. They said you had to buy the seat, you know, next to you as well. That didn't go over very well, and it didn't really last very long. Congress is actually investigating this as well because, you know, for safety reasons, the amount of time that you can exit an airplane in the case of an emergency is critical. And they need to review that to make sure that these narrowing spaces are not keeping people from the ability to exit a plane in the case of an emergency. So it seems that United Airlines now has also decided to make an account. And another thing you don't think about is that airplanes have a certain limit on weight so that they can actually get up in the air. And it seems that Americans in particular are getting larger, if you haven't noticed. And it seems that I guess it's really weird the way this story that I found is talking about it there. It seems that people weigh different in the summer than they weigh in the winter. And I guess that also has to do with the planes taking off because of the heat. You know, when it gets to be like well over 100 degrees, sometimes like out in the desert in Arizona or in Las Vegas, planes can't even take off because they don't have sufficient lift when the temperature gets too hot. So it seems that the requirements now, when they calculate the weight of a plane based on the number of passengers, the summer weights for females, the old weight that they averaged a woman that a passenger was going to be was 145 pounds. Now it's 179 pounds. So if you've noticed the women out there getting a little bit bigger, it's true. In winter, they increased it from 150 to 184. So I don't know if people eat more in the winter or what. For men, they've increased the average summer weight from 185 to 200 and the winter weight from 190 to 205. So listen to these numbers, figure out where you fit in, and you may have to go on a diet before you take your next flight. I don't know, but I just find it interesting that it takes so long and that, you know, we don't think about that. The other thing that happens is now with these new weights, if an airplane is sold out, which is typical these days, they may have to fly with a few empty seats. And keep in mind, too, if you get bumped off of a plane, check out your rights. You know, more often than not, you get bumped from a plane and the airline doesn't want to do anything to help you out. There are laws and requirements if they force you off of a plane that you have a ticket for, you signed in that you're there on time, and they throw you off. You do have rights. So first of all, we want to make sure that the plane is safe, that it could take off properly. We want to make sure, God forbid, there's an accident that you can get off the plane. But we also want to make sure that people who buy tickets get to the destination that they plan on going to. So trust me, I'm sure Congress will be investigating all of this. So we'll have more to report on in the coming months for sure. And I'm on a diet, so I don't want to be the reason why somebody gets thrown off the plane. So make sure that it's all good. I also wanted to have a shout out. I have Steve sitting across from me, and I'm here in my sunglasses in the studio today. And I wanted to give a shout out to my eye surgeon. 36 hours ago, I had surgery on both of my eyelids, and I drove down here to the station, and I'm here working because my surgeon, I hope, did an incredible job. We'll find out. I got to wait a couple of weeks for the final result, but not only did I get in and out quick, I didn't even take a Tylenol afterwards. So if anybody is debating eyelid surgery, I needed it for my vision. I was, you know, losing my vision, but sometimes as we all age and we want to age gracefully, you might want it for cosmetic reasons. You might need it for medical reasons. But this particular doctor, Dr. Connor, from Cosmetic and Oculoplastic and Orbital Consultants, Michael Connor, right here in Palm Beach Gardens, eyeliddocs.com. That's eyeliddocs.com. An amazing practice. from what I understand, and again, I'll see the results in a week or two and I'll fill you all in, but to go under the knife like that and 36 hours later to be out, you know, driving around and to have surgery and not even take a Tylenol afterwards, I was just amazed. So obviously you could always reach out to me if you want more information. Go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. Send me a message and I can talk more about it. If you're scared, I mean, I've been wanting this surgery for a while. I knew that my vision was starting to struggle a little bit. I researched it and found out that this is the guy, that this is all he does. And I can't emphasize enough, anytime you're picking a doctor or a surgeon, go to the guy that has the most experience. Don't go to the guy that's across the street or convenient. You want to go to the guy that you know, does this and does this well day in, day out. So thank you, Dr. Connor, eyeliddocs.com. I think what we're going to do is we're going to take another quick break, and I'll save an extra half a minute or so because I got a bunch of travel deals in our next segment. You're not going to want to miss it. This is the segment that we get the most feedback on. I know I salivate over these travel deals. I kind of feel like everybody does. I got some airfare deals today that are just incredible. So I think what you need to do is stay tuned, and we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show in just a brief minute.
Hi, golf and travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand, and when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. On a tour of one night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound. Thoughts escaping home, where my music's playing home, where my love lies waiting silently for me. Every day is an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. And each town looks the same to me, the movies and the factories, and every stranger's face I see reminds me that I love.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shube. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.